Public employees celebrated today's ruling as a victory, albeit potentially short-lived. As Colleen Henry reports, many view it as an opportunity to continue the fight against the collective bargaining bill.
News of the judge's ruling flew through the Milwaukee County Courthouse.
Travel fast, and it's wonderful to hear.
Yeah, it's like the dark cloud is going away and light is coming out.
From county security guards to the Milwaukee Teachers Union.
This validates our concerns all along them.
But, says Marquette Law Professor Paul Secunda, the victory may be temporary. Wisconsin's Supreme Court takes up the case in less than 2 weeks.
Even if the open meetings law challenge is overturned by the Supreme Court, there will be additional challenges on more of the substance of the law. Does it violate the federal constitution? Does it violate the state constitution? And so on.
Some local government officials say the uncertainty puts their budgets in peril. Waukesha County Executive Dan Vrakas says the ruling is a temporary setback to the much-needed reforms that will help local governments operate in a more efficient manner, keep taxes low, and deliver high-quality necessary services. But UWM Program Director Yolanda White says by blocking the law, the judge's decision could actually bring compromise.
I think just for a while might be long enough so that we can all get our heads together and work together to come up with something that'll work for state employees and will work for our governor.
The head of Milwaukee's teachers union hopes this will energize voters.
The people of Wisconsin will get involved in the elections that are coming up to make sure that we have responsible government returned to Wisconsin.
Mike Langell says if voters can unseat 3 Republicans in the state Senate, the collective bargaining bill could be dead. The first recall elections are set for July. In Milwaukee, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
The Supreme Court hears arguments on the collective bargaining bill on June 6th.